Good morning, good morning, good morning. Come on in, come on in. You are the risen King, seated in majesty. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, you have won it all just for me. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Yes, God. God bless you. Thank you all for being on this morning with us for our time of soap. And today, we want to jump in on a subject we talked about a while ago, but we haven't dealt with in a while. We want to talk about death. Shall we rejoice or shall we reap as Christians? My brothers and sisters, when a Christian dies, shall those of us who are believers weep or rejoice? The biblical answer is both, even simultaneously. I saw this in a new place as I was memorizing my way through Philippians a long time ago. I never noticed before the emotional contrast between Philippians 2, verses 17 and 18, and chapter 2, verse 27. An invitation to rejoice. In Philippians chapter 2, verses 17 and 18, Paul is describing the possibility of his own death as drink offering on the sacrificial offering of their faith. He is willing to die in the service of strengthening and purifying their faith. Then he says, if that happens, I am glad and rejoice with you all. Likewise, you also should be glad and rejoice with me. In verse 18, listen, not only does he rejoice at the prospect of his own death, but he tells them to rejoice with him. He already told them why he rejoices at the prospect of his death. He said, my desire is to depart and be with Christ, for that is far better, in Philippians chapter 1, verse 23. Now, presumably, my brothers and sisters, that is why he thinks they should rejoice also. They love Paul. So when Paul is with Christ, that will be far better. Jesus spoke this same way to his disciples. He said, if you love me, you would have rejoiced because I am going to the Father. For the Father is greater than I, in John chapter 14, verse 28. Catch this today. The Father is the splendor of God. He is greater than the Son in his suffering. What a liberation was coming when the Son's work here is done and he returns to his Father's glory. So he says, if you love me, then you would rejoice at my departure. So in experiencing this intense sorrow, but this is not the whole story. Check this out. 10 verses later in Philippians chapter 2, Paul praises Epaphroditus because he nearly died for the work of Christ in verse 30. But then he did not die, and Paul is glad. Here's what he says. Indeed, he was ill. He was near to death, But God had mercy on him, and not only on him, but on me also, lest I should have sorrow upon sorrow, in verse 27. Listen, God had mercy on Paul, lest he should have sorrow upon sorrow. In other words, he did not let Epaphroditus die so that Paul would not have that grief on top of all his other burdens he was already carrying. So when Paul said, "Rejoice with me," at the prospect of his own death in Philippians chapter 2, verse 18, that was not the whole emotional story. Paul would have experienced grief upon grief if Epaphroditus had died. And this is not because Epaphroditus was unprepared to die. Stay with me. He was as ready as Paul. And it says, "Honor such men, for he nearly died for the work of Christ," in chapter 2, verse 30. So what we have is a complex harmony, good deacon. I see you, Taylor. What should we conclude from these two texts, Sister D? We should conclude that our sorrows at the death of a believer are joyful sorrows. And our rejoicing at the death of a believer is a sorrowful rejoicing. There is nothing hopeless about the sorrow, and there is nothing flippant or exciting about the joy. The joy hurts, and the sorrow is softened with invincible hope. This is why one of the most common watchwords of the Christian life is sorrowful, yet always rejoicing, in 2 Corinthians 6 and 10. Sorrow and joy are not merely sequential. They are simultaneous. This is not emotional schizophrenia. This is a complex harmony of the Christian soul. Therefore, when a Christian dies, don't begrudge the tears and don't belittle the joy in the lover's eyes. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come today casting our cares and our pains upon you. Lord, we sorrowfully rejoice. God, we give you joy through all things. God, we give you the glory. We give you the praise. And Father, we pray right now that you would continue to be with us. Continue to walk with us, continue to guide us through all of the many emotions of life. And we'll be careful, God, hallelujah, to say thank you that you are able, God, to give us a hope that does not die in death. God, we thank you today for the hope that we have in resurrection through Christ Jesus. God, we thank you today for our ancestors. We thank you today for our loved ones and our relationships, God. And we thank you, God, for that great cloud of witnesses that is standing in heaven in glory with Christ Jesus, that one day, God, we shall see again. God, we thank you today for that great cloud of witnesses, God, that are shouting today, God, giving glory, trying to get us to understand how they have made it over. And we say thank you now, God, in Jesus' name. We give you glory. We give you praise. We give you honor. Amen and thank God. Listen, my brothers and sisters, God bless you. God keep you. I pray this word has been a blessing for you today. Go ahead, like this post, share this post. We're trying to get the word out. God bless you. Peace till next time.